And welcome back, it's the Clay Golem here. We're back in Foundry VTT version 12. We're building Curse of Strahd. Yeah, I'm trying to push on with this and get as many of these scenes done and things as I can. So we're currently working specifically on the Into the Valley part of it. So this is the journey between the village of Barovia and getting to the Sir Paul. T-S-E-R. I'm thinking like Tsars, as in like the Tsars of Russia, which is spelt with a T. Am I pronouncing that wrong? Zerpal? Anyway, it's like one of those things, as long as you're consistent, it doesn't matter if you mispronounce stuff, alright? The players won't necessarily know, that's fine. So, we've already got the Barovian scouts, we did that in the previous video of these, that come in. We've got the Svalich Road, which is just the journey itself, or the Van Richten's cache, depending which way you want to say it, if they find out about the clue from the Barovian scouts and they come off the path, not from the Barovian scouts, Durrow, I think it is, who talks about the cache, and they come here. So we've got a couple more scenes to do for this area into the valley. The next one is going to be the River Ivlis, got that right? Yep, Ivlis Crossroads. So we're going to be building this scene here. Nice and simple area, in theory. Actually have to configure and bring my map in. Don't want it in navigation, just going to bring my map in. So obviously you guys have seen me do these kind of things loads and loads of times before. Understand if you want to skip this video, by all means do so, it's up to you. I'm building it anyway, so it's no skin off my nose either direction. All right, so now I want to do something slightly different with this, because this is their first encounter with Strahd. So I wanted to do a couple of options here. Hang on, brain. Come on, brain. Right, so first of all, my main map that I want to bring in. There we go. Thank you very much. All optimized. Gonna make my grid red so that I'll be able to see it. And I want to put on global illumination. There it is. All right, so first of all, I want to make sure my grid is sensible size. And you know what? That's not too bad, is it? On that path, two abreast on that path, that makes sense. It's got to be wide enough for a wagon. I'm going to go with that. So yeah, so this is potentially their first encounter. Well, no, it probably is their first encounter with Strahd if things go to plan. But I want to make sure that this is kind of atmospheric, so I want this to stay kind of as the, you know, the RP theater of the mind side of it, rather than instant battle map. But if they decide to dick around with Strahd, absolutely battles can ensue. So if so, I want to have this battle map ready. So in order for that to be ready, I'm going to need, look at my monsters. I don't have any direwolves in. Yes, I do have direwolves in. So I'm going to slap out direwolves. Now, the module suggests that there should be one direwolf per member of the party. Now, this is supposed to be ridiculously difficult. Ideally, the party would be third level at this point. That's a tough combat, even if you take out the fact that Strahd's there. Because they're not supposed to fight here. Well, rather, they're definitely not supposed to win here. That's probably a better way of putting it. So I'm pulling these guys out. How many have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because my group, 7 players. So I do need to make sure. And I like the fact it says 1 per player character to get the balance right. It's like, yeah, thanks. That's actually really, really helpful. What I also need is, for the first time, I actually need to bring Strahd himself in. Now, they cannot defeat Strahd in this encounter. We talk about railroading and not railroading players, because it's really important for them not to feel completely helpless and that they are just NPCs in the DM story. Curse of Strahd is different. There are certain bits where you are deliberately railroading them to give them the feeling of helplessness and despair and that lack of control, and that's done purposefully. Now, all through this, There are some instances where that is really key. For example, they cannot avoid ending up in Barovia. So we start off with the Vastani camp, and they go there, and they're asked to go and visit Madame Eva. And on that journey, they find the gates of Ravenloft, and they willingly walk through into Ravenloft. What happens if they refuse to do it? They butcher all the Vastani or something silly like that. The campaign's ruined. So they can still have that option, but the mists of Ravenloft will scoop them up and deposit them outside of the Death House anyway. So we take that away. Ravenloft, Barovia wants them, and it will take them. So again, out of control. But they're then in the Death House, and they've got full reign to do what they want in the Death House, make their own decisions, though they can't leave until they solve it in one of the two main ways. They've then got the whole of access to Barovia, the village, to do what they want, to talk to the people. So they're under their own steam of what they want to investigate, and they can leave whenever they like. So they've got plenty of times when they can do it. But really, the only way if they go the other way and they go back to the gates are locked and they ain't getting out. Simple as that. So they don't have a lot of choice but to come along this road and end up at some point having this encounter. Which is good, because we're pointing them in the direction of the adventure. Here, they've got freedom to handle this however they like. They can have a conversation, they can attempt to run for their lives, they can attempt to fight. They've still got that freedom, but Strahd is indestructible at this point, because, you know, some magical way they managed to destroy him. Game over. It would be rubbish, wouldn't it? So I'm going to create an actor, and I'm not going to fill him out. Let me make sure I spell his name right, hey? That's typical, I haven't got it here. Let's just call him Strahd for the moment, that'll do. Shut up, alright? and I definitely want to put my image on. Now, I've already got him somewhere in here. He's going to be in my token images, is he? Nope, so let's pull him in. Excuse me if you can hear the crows outside. That's very atmospheric, isn't it, for doing Strahd? you in here? Where did I put my picture of Strahd? This is why I need to make sure I've organised myself. Is in the landing page. Right, so I'm going to use that one. Thank you very much. There we go. So at least I've got this character. Again, it's going to be any kind of combat is going to be a role play event here. What I will do is I'm going to select all of those, and I'm going to hide them. And I'm going to hide him as well, because I don't want them at this point. Because if they just have a conversation, they're not going to see the token. Alright, so this lot is going to potentially all be hidden unless they decide to have a scrap, in which case I will reveal it. Alright, so assuming they're not stupid enough to get into a fight with Strahd and his seven direwolves at this point, I want a different scene. So I'm going to overlay this with a tile, let's create that tile that's going to be the full size of this. Thank you very much. And I'm going to find the path for it. I'm going to make sure I'm saving it in my correct place in my scenes folder. And the one that I want is, of course, I'm all over the place, into the valley. There we go. So the scene I want to use when they arrive here is going to be this one over here. So thank you very much, Optimizer. So we can bring that in. Boom. So this is actually the scene that they're going to see when they first arrive here. So again, more theatre of the mind rather than battle map, unless it needs to become a battle map. All right, so I'm going to have to put some buttons on here. So first, before we do that though, before we do that, I'm going to bring in a couple of other elements. So what happens here when they arrive is, you know, soon the river bends once more out of sight of the dark woods surrounding the road once again. Finally, Finally, though, the trees pull away to reveal a tall cliff. Yes, you can't really see that in this. At the base of a foggy mountain slope, the air is cold and damp here, and soft wisps of fog swirl around the base of the cliff, and you approach at a junction in the road where there is a smaller path that leads off to the right. Standing at the junction is an old rickety hanging gallows, and you can see further off to the right in the distance a small graveyard. Now, I know my gallows is on the right, and on the battle map is on the left. Whatever, deal with it. I've generated all these images, and I couldn't get one that I liked that actually had it on the left. It was insisting on putting the gallows on the right. But this will do. This will do absolutely fine. It's not a problem. Those little details, like I say, the chances are they won't see the battle map anyway. If I roleplay Strahd right, they won't be stupid enough to try and fight him. There we go. That's my challenge, isn't it? But I'm ready for it because I'm not that confident. Okay, so I now want to place out another tile for here. Again, just check I'm in the right place before I select it. And what I do want to do is put out his coach. Okay, so we're going to put out his coach here arriving. I'm going to make that a fair bit bigger. And I'm going to slide that perhaps up here. So again, I can talk about the fact that his coach pulls along from the road in front of them, and then they can have that conversation. So I'm going to lock that there. That will do nicely. And I'm also going to make that invisible because I don't want them seeing that straight away. But also, I want to put in an image of my direwolf here. Again, just checking that's in the same right place. I want to put in this image of a direwolf, so if they start to get all a bit, you know, let's mess with Strahd, and he call his direwolves pad out, I can just reveal that. So they've got an idea of the scale of the direwolves, because on the map, these top-down things, if they get into that combat, the tokens don't really do it justice, so I want to make sure that Strahd's carriage arriving is a dramatic event. It's impactful. It's going to make them nervous straight away. And then if those direwolves start peering out of the woods, I want them immediately going, holy crap, we're in trouble here. Okay, there's seven of them. They're the size of small horses. They are vicious. They've got glowing golden eyes. Do not mess with them. That's what I want them to be thinking straight away, regardless of the fact that Strahd is standing there. I want them to be going, we don't want to get into this fight just with the direwolves. You know, because those direwolves are going to be bigger than half the party each, and they got one each. It's dangerous. Right. So I need to put some buttons on. So first of all, what do I need to do? I want several buttons. One is Strahd's coach to reveal and then fade away after he's left. I want the direwolf to fade in and then fade away as well. And then I potentially have a button for hit combat, which will hide all of these tiles and leave us with, leave us with the combat battle map in the background. So I'm going to go to drawing tools here and go alphabet, and I'm just going to go edit this one. And the text I'm going to put is coach, just coach, that will do, just call it coach, that's fine. I'm then going to copy this, I'm going to paste it because, you know, I'm lazy. That'll do. I'm going to just have this label as whoop, direwolf, and this one I'm just going to label as combat. So this is really simple use of Monk's active tile triggers here. Of course, what I need to then do is place a tile underneath this. So that'll do nicely. Thank you very much. I am going to use my back buttons things because I like those. Oops, I think it was in wasn't in item images. I think it was in, no, it wasn't in there. I put it in my landing page thing. I don't want to keep keep uploading the same image repeatedly. So I can bring in my coach there and put that in. I can then go to create my next button here. And again, I want to use that same one. There we go, button background, that will do. Thank you very much. And then my last one here as well. I'm aware that they're not quite lined up. I'll sort that in a second. Button background there. Good. Right. So let's line these things up a bit nicer. There we go. They don't have to be exact. They just have to be close enough that when I press the button. Now, I do want to make sure, select these drawings, that they are hidden from the players, so the players can't see them, which is good. And also what I want to do is go to the crossroads here, configure, and I want to make the background color black. All right, so it gets rid of that harsh kind of border for the players from like the scene to a gray. It's like, yeah, just make it all black. Let's keep it nice and themic. And then my buttons stand out a bit nicer as well. All right, so these buttons, what do I need to do with them? Tile controls on the coach one. All this is going to do, active tiles. We've done this a number of times. Really simple. Control by GM only. And it's going to be a click. All right, we don't need to worry about sight. And we can definitely do it when paused. Obviously, as the Dungeon Master, we can do it anyway. And the actions is simply going to... I've missed a step. Hang on. Go back. Right. Coach tile. I have to remember that to use tagger. Okay. So let's call this... This is part of Act 1. R-I-C. Coach. Okay. So... add that tag and update that. So when I'm doing this one, the action I want is simply that show hide. That's all I need to do here is show hide and use the tag. Thank you very much. And I'm going to toggle it. And as usual, I'm going to put a little 3 second delay on there. That's it. That button's done. Okay. Now what I do need to do, of course, is make sure I've put a tag on the direwolf as well. So that was a river crossing direwolf. And if I copy it, then I can't accidentally mistype it. When I do the same for the direwolf one, onto those triggers, it's going to be the GM only. We don't want it on enter, we want it on click. Thank you very much. Force of habit changing those. Actions add, we want to show hide. Whoop. Add that tag in, want to toggle, give it a 3 second delay, job done. Right, so the next one is this main tile here. I need to give this a tag as well. Let's just call it gallows. It doesn't really matter. So when I'm using these tags, this beginning bit, I'm trying to relate it to which act it is and then which scene it is. So RIC is the initials for the River Ivlis Crossroads. The idea being is that when I create other tags later on, even if there's one for the gallows, I'm not going to accidentally reuse the same tag and potentially cause myself problems, because that would be bad, okay? We don't want that. Okay, so combat, what this is actually going to do, it's not very much. So GM only, it's going to be a click. Change those, just a force of habit. And the actions for this is going to be show hide again. But all this is going to do is, hang on, we're going to hide. I'll have that fade out. We're going to hide. Let's grab that one as well. Again, just make sure that I'm using the correct one. We're also going to make sure that we're hiding these. They should already be hidden, but they might not be. And it just saves me then having to also hide those. And then this one was just called Direwolf, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. button. That's the one. So even if I forget to hide the direwolf before then hiding the main scene, it's this button will just hide them all. One click, you're into combat. Good luck. Those are going to fade out. Okay, so that's kind of it. That's the scene. Now, this is a big role-playing scene. So the players should see this. We click coach, and the coach should appear out of the mists. Now, again, in the DM view, it doesn't look so great. So because we can see all of the tiles over the top of each other. That direwolf comes in because it's got a brighter background. You can see that comes in a bit clearer. And then if we hit combat, there we go. And again, because we're in the DM view, we can still see the tiles over the top of it. But you can clearly see the map in the background there. Now, problem is, I've got to reset this. Sometimes, when I'm playing with these things a lot and it's quite complicated, like the landing page, I build a reset button that just sets everything back. Not really necessary in this case. All I need to do is that one. That's it. I just need to show that one again, because these ones will show over the top of the battle map as well if I want to. So that's pretty much ready to go. That's an entire scene done, even though this is potentially quite a long scene because there's lots of RP with Strahd. Do I need a tile of Strahd himself? Possibly, rather than just his token, I might want a bigger when Strahd actually talks to them. What I don't have is a full length view of Strahd. I've only got that token image. No, don't want to do that. Give me a new one. Yeah, so this is potentially... No, I'm in landing page. Can you tell I'm thinking? Tell I'm thinking while I'm talking to you. Yeah, I think that's about right. So what I could do is, while they're talking, is I could literally bring in this image of him for the conversation. So I could add that button on as well, couldn't I? Because I don't have a full one of him. I think I'll do that. So I'm going to lock this one here and hide it. Now, obviously, I need to put a tag on here. So I'm going to follow the same rules. The River Idris Crossing. Because I don't want to accidentally have all my Strahds all over the whole place showing and hiding. Okay, so we can update that tile. Yep, that's all we need to do. But I do need a new button. So the easiest way to do that, of course, is to copy, paste that in there. Let's call that Strahd. And then for my actual button itself, again, I can just copy and paste that one and just update this one because it's going to do the same thing. Under my actions, of course, I just need to change that tag. That's it. Done. Easy peasy. So, yeah, we can fade Strahd in. Again, it's not going to look brilliant on here because of the... just the overlapping of the tiles. The Direwolf one works best because it's on that background. So let's just quickly check to make sure... That tile is hidden. That tile is hidden. That tile is hidden now. Okay, good. That's it. So a major encounter here, but very easily put together, atmospheric. What I haven't put on here, of course, is I probably want on the crossing. I've put lighting. I haven't put anything on the ambience. So FX Master, I want FX Master back, please. I know it's on here and it is kind of working, but bearing in mind I'm trying to build this. See, that fog is just too heavy for this purpose. Ooh, Let's play with something. Let's play. Oh, we did that on the road and it was just too harsh, wasn't it? It would work with FX Master. I might have to FX the person who mods FX Master. I'm gonna see if I can get in touch and find out what the state of play of that is, because I want to use it, but I also don't want to package that with this module and then find out it breaks. So leave that one with me. I'll see what I can do about getting a functional one for that. But what I do want is I do want to use my background forest Windy Woods playlist. So here we're going to have some, hopefully you can hear it and it's not too loud for you. We should have some background things. Okie dokie. Right, that's it. Just one scene all in one go. Nicely done. We've got one more to do after this. I'm going to do it in a separate video just because of time wise. And that's going to be the Strix, which is an encounter that is going to be a combat. So I'm just going to get my images and stuff sorted, and I'll see you in the next one. You take care now. Bye bye.